Today we're going to do a demo dissection of a sheep heart, and that's what I have in tray in front of me. This is a preserved sheep heart. The top of the heart is the widest part, and oddly enough, it's called the base. It tapers down to a point which is called the apex. Now, most of the heart is ventricles. So all of this, from here down, is ventricles. And the heart is divided up into two ventricles. This line that separates roughly the two ventricles, you want to position the heart so that this line crosses from your right to your left, and the apex is on your right. This would be looking at the anterior surface of the heart. If the heart were in a sheep or a person and you were looking at them face on. Now, when you talk about right or left, you talk about the heart's right or left as it sits inside the person's chest or the sheep's chest. So if this is the anterior surface, then this is the left ventricle, the part that has the apex. This is the left ventricle. From this septum, this way, this is the right ventricle. So this is the sheep's right ventricle, the sheep's left ventricle. At the top, or the base of the heart, we have these two ear-like structures, which are called auricles. So this would be the auricle servicing the left ventricle. Therefore, this is the left auricle. Here is the auricle servicing the right ventricle. So this is the right auricle. The major vessels have been cut kind of close at the slaughterhouse, unfortunately. But we can still see some of them. This is probably the aorta, this vessel right here, this big opening, and some of the other major vessels, which we'll talk about later. There is a certain amount of fat around the heart. This is a normal amount. The fat outside the heart has a job of cushioning the heart as it fills with blood and then contracts. So this fat does not endanger the heart. It's the fat that accumulates in the coronary arteries, the arteries that bring blood to the heart muscle. And this gray stuff is the heart muscle. That's what we don't want, because that fat inside these vessels can plug up the blood flow and the heart muscle could die. Once you've found all of these landmarks, then we're going to dissect the heart. We're going to put it on its base and take a scalpel and cut through both ventricles. So we want to make sure we cut through the right ventricle and the left ventricle. And it's going to be a hard going because this ventricle is very thick. It's made of thick cardiac muscle, especially the left side. The left ventricle has the thickest cardiac muscle of all four chambers. So you might want to start with the scalpel and cut down, and then maybe take a scissors and finish the job. You don't want to cut it completely through. You want to leave a hinge at the base. This looks like one of those cooking shows. If you preheat the oven at 350, and we're going to cut through the septum in between the two ventricles. So now it looks like the jaws of an alligator, and we can see the various parts. This is the lumen, or the chamber of the right ventricle, here and here. And this is the chamber of the left ventricle, Now you can tell right away which is right and which is left. If you look at the thickness of the wall, the cardiac muscle, the myocardium of the right ventricle, it is much smaller than that of the left. See, this is much thicker. The septum, this is the septum that divides the two ventricles. Now, there are four one-way valves associated with the heart. If we look on the right side, here is a flap of the AV valve, the atrioventricular valve on the right side, which is called the tricuspid valve. So this is one cusp or flap of that valve. This would be another, and here is the third, that right here. Attached to the underside of the cusps are these little strings that I'm ripping right now. And these are the chordae tendinae. And the other end of these little chordae tendinae are attached to bumps of muscle from the ventricle wall called the papillary muscles. And these little bumps right where the forceps are the papillary muscles. Notice how thick these chordae tendinae are and how thick the valve flap is. It's not very thick. If we look at the counterpart of this valve on the left side, this is the bicuspid or mitral valve. You can see that the valve flap is very thick. The chordae tendinae are much thicker, and the papillary muscles are much bigger. Everything is heavy duty on the left side because higher pressures are generated. The left side is the systemic pump. It has to pump blood through all parts of the body, whereas the right side is the pulmonary pump. It just has to pump blood to the lungs. We're looking through into the atria. So this would be the left atrium, and beyond this valve up here is the right atrium. What we're going to do next is close this, take a probe, and we can do this one of two ways. I know this is the pulmonary artery, so I can stick the wooden end of the probe through the pulmonary artery, and it should open up into the right ventricle right here. Well, let's see. Let's open up the heart. I don't know if you can see that, but there's the wooden probe. So we have the probe through the pulmonary artery. What I want to do now is keep the probe in place, take the scalpel or a scissors, and cut, opening up the pulmonary artery to take a look at the pulmonary semilunar valve. So we're just going to open that. And maybe I'll cut right through. I feel sorry for the poor cameraman who has to follow all this. We're going to take the probe out and see if we can open up this pulmonary artery. I don't know if you can see these little pockets here. There's one pocket of the semilunar, pulmonary semilunar valve. Here is a second pocket. And on this side, there should be a third pocket. Okay, so these three pockets make up the pulmonary semilunar valve. When blood flows out of the ventricle into the artery, these pockets are pushed against the wall. When the right ventricle relaxes, the last blood tends to fall back into the ventricle, but it can't. It catches the pockets. Each pocket then opens up, and when all three pockets open, they close off the lumen or the space, and no blood can go backflow into the ventricle. There is a similar setup, another semilunar valve in the aorta, which is the major artery right here. And I'm going to show you that valve on the human heart. So what we're going to do is just switch here. We can keep the camera rolling. This is a preserved human heart that's all dissected, and we've had it for years. It doesn't look like much. Try to get it all together. I don't think this person died of a broken heart, but it certainly seems it. Let's look at the right side. This is the right ventricle. This valve is the tricuspid valve flap. Here are chordae tendinae from the tricuspid. And here's another valve flap. Again, notice that the valve flaps are not very big, that the chordae tendinae are not that big. And here, and my fingernail is part of a papillary muscle. Those aren't very big. All right. And above the tricuspid valve, this area here would be the right atrium. Now, remember how these valve flaps looked and how thick the right ventricle wall is. If we turn this over and look at the left side, look how much thicker the left ventricle wall is. Let's take a look at the mitral valve or bicuspid valve flap. Here it is right here. Much, much thicker than the tricuspid valve flap. If we look at the chordae tendinae, they are much more prominent, and the papillary muscles are bigger. So everything's heavy duty because of the increased pressures on the left side. One of the reasons why I want to show you the human heart is here in the aorta. This is the major artery of the body. So if we close it up, you're looking down into the aorta, and you can see the flaps of the aortic semilunar valve. So if we open this up, here is one flap, two flaps, and here is part of the third. But the interesting thing is, if we look at the artery wall, we see these yellow deposits. You won't find these in the sheep heart, since the sheep eat a much better diet than we do and don't live as long. But these are fatty plaques, or atherosclerotic plaques. And with a big vessel like the aorta, they don't really hamper blood flow. But right here is an opening of one of the coronary arteries. If you can imagine if this much plaque were stuffed into a smaller artery like the coronary artery, that would block blood flow to the heart muscle. And that happens all too often in humans. So I wanted to show you this heart specifically to show you what plaque looks like. And there's even some fatty plaque here in the valve flap of the mitral or bicuspid valve. And that concludes the demo dissection of the heart.